Okay, so now let's talk about FTP, and I'm going to refer to our class site, which is a WordPress site, and you'll notice that up in the top navigation, the one all the way to the right says FTP info. And if I click on that, we'll see that for my FTP information, I have lower down in the class notes all of the information that you'll need to connect to the server. Okay, and we have the host name, the login, and the password. So that's all the information that you're going to need to connect to the class server. For those of you who at any other time want to connect to another type of server, maybe you have purchased some server space, it would be done the same way. You would just need to know your FTP host, your login, and your password. Okay, so that's where you get that important information. So let me open up Dreamweaver again here, and where we're going to do our uploading via FTP is through the site window of Dreamweaver. So I'm going up to very top here under site, and I'm going to select new site. Okay, now there are two interfaces. There's a basic interface and an advanced. I'm actually going to use the advanced, so make sure that you are using that. And also you'll notice on this left-hand side, there's lots of different categories, but we're actually only going to use the local info and the remote info. Those are the only two places we're going to fill in information. Okay, so under local info, the first field we're going to fill in is site name, and I'm just going to right now call this website. I normally will call it, you know, something that corresponds to the project I'm working on. So for right now, we'll just call it website. And the next one below it is really important. It's the local root folder. And what we're doing is we're telling Dreamweaver where our file structure is located on our computer. So I'm going to go over to the folder on the side here, and I'm going to browse for it so we know it's on my desktop. And we also know that I put that final web folder, which is where all of my website files live, in this Graphic Design 66 folder. And this is where a lot of students will make a mistake. They will oftentimes pick the final web folder as the local root folder. And what will happen is when they upload, the only thing that will upload will be all the individual files. And we actually, for our purposes in class, want to upload the entire folder. So I'm going to pick the folder above my final web folder, which is this Graphic Design 66 folder. Okay, so I'm going to select that and hit choose. And that is all I need to do for this local info. So I'm going to move on to remote info. I'm going to pick my access as FTP. And here's where I'm going to put in my FTP host information. And again, this is in the class notes. So we have everything about web.com. So ftp.everythingaboutweb.com is the host. Our login is Graphic Design 66 online. And our password is Design 66, and then it's web dev, and the W and the D are capitalized, and it is case sensitive, so you do want to make sure that you are capitalizing those two letters. And I'm going to test it right here. The other thing that you may have to check off is this used passive FTP. So I'm going to check that off, and then I'm going to hit this test button, and sure enough, I have inputted the content correctly, so we are now going to be able to connect to the server. So I'm going to hit OK here. Okay, and we get this window. Now, oftentimes, you're going to find that your window here isn't going to show expanded like this. It might show actually in a more collapsed form. In fact, it may actually look more like this on the side. This is oftentimes where students get confused because once they connect, it's going to open up like this and they're not always sure where they need to go. You need to expand this little, using this little window pane icon so that you get this window, which is basically just showing you your local files over here, and eventually on the left-hand side, it's going to show you what's on the server. Okay, so that can be a little bit confusing, and I have outlined that more clearly in the class notes also. So I do encourage you to read the class notes about the FTP info. So the last step here is to click on these little connection buttons up here on the top. And when I do that, I'm going to be able to connect. And we can see that there's actually nothing on the server right now. So my very last step, I want that to show up. So I'm going to now just simply drag this over into this big blue folder and drop it. And Dreamweaver is asking me, do I want to put dependent files? And in this case, I'm going to say no, because I'm putting all the files up. Dependent files would be if you're just uploading, let's say you made a change to the homepage, and let's say it involved changing an image on the homepage. In that case, you might want to say yes, because you'd want Dreamweaver to also upload that image in addition to your HTML page. But since we're uploading everything, I can say no for dependent files. We'll see on the left-hand side that indeed my final web folder has been uploaded. So the final step that I need to do, and I'm going to go back to our class notes because I do have this in our class notes. You'll see halfway down the page there is a URL of where you can see your site that has been uploaded. So I'm going to click on that, and sure enough, here we are at that URL, which is www.everythingaboutweb.com/graphicdesign66online, and you can see my final web folder. So if I had anything in that index page, once I clicked on this final web, you'd be able to see that. So I encourage you as your very last step to go to this site and make sure that your web files are showing up and that all of your links are working, that all of your images are working, and that is how you upload a site using Dreamweaver. So please read through the class notes. I also have some additional resources at the end of the class notes on FTP information, and also you're welcome to put any additional questions you have about FTP up in the discussion area on the class site. So that's it. Thank you so much.